हेलो माय डियर स्टूडेंट, वेलकम टू नागेश करसगे ऑर्किड स्कूल चैनल। माय सेल्फ हिना पटेल, गोइंग टू टीच यू मैथमेटिक्स फॉर द ग्रेड 5। यस, वी हैड स्टार्टेड विद द सेकंड चैप्टर, दैट इज ऑपरेशंस विद अ लार्ज नंबर। वी हैड कवर्ड द डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ ऑपरेशंस, वी हैड सॉल्व द एग्जाम्पल्स एंड ऑल द कॉन्सेप्ट्स आर क्लियर बाय यू। ओके, नाउ इन द प्रीवियस क्लास वी हैड लर्न अबाउट द एवरेज। जस्ट वी विल गो इन डिटेल व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ एवरेज and what are the type of sums and why we are using the word average. Yes, we will start. What is an average where we are using in our daily life? Yes, when the group of things we will get in a one number, single number, that is nothing but average. We can compare the having the average, we can compare the strength of the two class, marks of the two class. And what is the formula for average? Yes, average is equal to sum of all observations upon number of all observation. Upon means it is nothing but in the form of division. Average is equal to sum of, what is the meaning of sum here? It is nothing but we have to do all the addition here. Whatever the observations means, it may be the number of marks, it may be the number of runs, it may be the distance traveled by a train. There may be different things that you have to do the addition. And number of observation means how many subjects marks or how many students marks or how many class marks, that number you have to write here. So average is equal to sum of all the observations upon the number of all the observation. Here the in the previous class we had learned this, find the average of 5, 10 and 15. Yes, what are your observations? Are nothing but 5, 10 and 15. Should we write as it is? No. Here the word is sum, means we have to add 5 plus 10 plus 15, that should be written in the numerator. And number of observation, how many observations you are having? 3, 1, 2 and 3, that should be divided by 3. So this formula everyone should know, what is an average. We will see one example here. The test marks in the mathematics of a fifth top students in the sections A and section B of class 5th are given. Here we are having section A, section B. Top students who are in the class, we got a marks of that students, that is mathematics. The one of the students got out of out, that is 100 out of 100, 99, 98, 97, 91. I want to compare that which section is performed well. Means what? I want to compare, means I will do first find out the average, after that can I go for 1-1 marks? No, I can't do the comparison here. 100, here is 99. Again there are 5 students, each and every students are not having similar marks of section A and B. So what should I do? I should go for first find the average. In the previous slide we had seen what is the meaning, what is the formula for average. Same we have to apply. Given below, which group has performed better? Average means sum of the observation. What is the sum of observation? Section A. These are the 5 students' marks of mathematics. We have to do the addition. Sum means we have to do addition. The total is 485. Here in the section B also, we have to do the addition of the top 5 students of section B. The total is 485. By seeing the total, you can compare. Yes, but we are learning the average, so we have to use the formula for the average for section A and for the section B. What is the average? Is total marks. You had know that what was the total marks? 485 upon total number of students. How many students marks we had considered? Only 5, that is top 5 students of 5th grade of mathematics subject. So it is divided by 5. So total was 485 of section A, which is divided by total number of students was 5. So after division we will get at 97. What is 97? Is nothing but average of that class, that is section A of 5th grade. Here we are having for the same formula we have to use for section B. What is the average? Total marks upon total number of students. What was the marks? Yes, 485 upon 5. do the division, we will get as 97. Now section B also got an average of 97 and section A also got the average of 97. So here we can say average marks of section A is 97 and B is 97. You can see that the average marks of student in both sections are 97, means both have performed well in their test. We can say that the student in both sections have performed equally well. This is not clear if we compare the individual marks obtained by student. Means what? If you individually you compare the marks of first student with the first students of section B, we can't get clear idea of section A and section B. If you are comparing second, he might be getting 100, he might be having 99. So it is not possible to compare one students with another section students who got the marks. So it is not clear by doing individually, but when we will have an average, so after calculating we can say both the section have performed equally, that is they had got the average of 97 marks in the mathematics subject. So before solving, you just read out the statement and write the formula, so it will help you to solve the example. Next, we will practically solve this. Find the average of a first 10 counting number. What are the counting number? I think so you had learned in LKG, UKG. Now first it is the word average, so we have to write an formula for an average. Average is equal to sum of observation upon number of observation. What is sum of observation? By reading the question, find the average of first 10 counting number. What are the counting number? Yes, first 10, 1. Sum means I have to go for plus, then 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. Are these first 10? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10? Yes, this is the first 10 counting number. I have to find out the average of this. So number of observation is how much? 10. Can you do the counting of this? Yes, everyone can do, but it will be some long method. No, I will give some small trick. Here we are having as a 10. So this is your 1 time 10. Then you can add 9 plus 1 is 10. 8 plus 2 is 10. Now 7 plus 3 is 10. Then 6 plus 4 is 10. And what is left is 5. So what will be the total? 10, 10, 10, 10, 5 times. So it is 50 and plus 5 is 55. So what will be our total here? What will be our sum? Is 55 upon 10. Now already you know the decimal and the fraction. So you can, without doing practical division, you can do. What answer we will get here is, yes, we are having 10 in the denominator. So we have to leave one digit from right hand side and we have to give a decimal point. So it is 5.5. What is 5.5? Is an average of a first 10 counting number. This is the first 10 counting number I had written. Yes, nothing I had done. After that, my formula was that sum, I had done the total, I had written the number of observation is how much? Is 10. So I think so everyone understood what is an average and how to find out the average of any given. Here I am having first 10 counting number. Suppose my question is, find out the average of a 6 multiples of a 2, first 6 multiples of a 2 means what? First 6 multiples of a 2. So here average is equal to, you know, sum of observation upon number of observation. I told 6 multiples, first 6 multiples of 2 means what? 2 1s are 2, this is 1, then 2 2s are 4, then this will be 6, then it will be 10, then 2 4 6 8 10 and 12, 1 2 3 4 5 and 6. These are 6 multiples of 2, first 6. So what should I do? I have to do the total, that is sum, and what will be the number of observation is 6. What should I write? 2 plus 4 plus 6 plus 8 plus 10 plus 12. Now my dear student, you can find out the total and you can divide it, so that is nothing but an average of first 6 multiples of 2. I had given my one of the example that you can understand what type of a questions may be there, but it will be very similar by using a formula. We have to find out the average. Now here I am having some complicated big word problem. It's not complicated, I will make you, it's very easy. In a factory, 6 workers gets a weekly salary of rupees 1250. Means what? In a factory, how many workers were working? 6 workers. How much salary of each worker is? 1250. So what should I do? First, I will find the average of 6 workers with their salary. Next, and 9 other workers get a weekly salary rupees 1500. There is again 9 more workers whose salary is different, that is salary is rupees 1500 per week. Find the average of salary of a worker. Now total we have to find out what will be the average of a salary of a one worker. Means it's not a complicated. I told you, first we will find out the average of 6 workers with its salary, and second time we will find out the average of 9 workers with its salary. So we will try. What will be there? Average is equal to sum of observation upon number of observation. What is sum of observation? I am having 6 workers, so my number of workers are 6. What is the salary of each worker is 1250. Another worker is also having 1250. Next 1250 plus 1250 plus 1250, 1 2 3 4 5 and this is 1250 6. Because 6 workers all are having the salary same, that is one worker is having 1250, second worker same, third, fourth, fifth and sixth. What it is? It is a salary, so we will write rupees. It no need to do the additions every time writing a rupees, rupees, rupees. So we will in the last we will write the amount. Now doing this addition, 1250, 1250, 1250, 1250, is very complicated. Yes, I had in the previous class only we had learned that repeated addition is nothing but a multiplication. So what should we have to do? A smart work? Yes. How many time? It is a 6 time. So I will multiply it by 6. So what will be here? 6 zeros are 0, 6 fives are 30, 3 carry, 6 2s are 12, 13, 14 and 15, 1 carry, 6 1 is 6 plus 1 is 7. What is, how much rupees? The total salary of this all workers together is 7500 divided by 6. What we had done in the previous example, same we had done, nothing extra, but here we are having something large number, and that is nothing but in a form of a rupees. So what will be the average? We will see, because my question is not completed. I will note down here and we will go for the second question. So average for the 6 workers is rupees 7500 upon 6. Now we will go for second question, that is, there have been total 9 workers are there and their salary is rupees 1500. 9 workers, salary is 1500 plus 1500, how many time I have to write? 9 time. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. Yes, but I told what smart work we have to do. It's not easy to do the total whole. So what is repeated addition is nothing but multiplication. So we will multiply 1500 multiplied by how many workers? 9 workers. So 9 zeros are 0, 0, 9 5s are 45, 9 ones are 9, 10, 11, 12 and 13. So how much total is 13,500 upon 9. What is this? This is 9 workers weekly salary with their per worker is 1500. So we got total average of this. Now find the average salary of worker means what? Now our formula as it is, we got this one average and this is our previous, this is 2 average we got. We will write here and we will try to find out what will be the average salary of this. So what should I do here? Here is 13,500 upon 9 plus 7,500 upon 6. Now sum, we have to do the observation of a sum. What will be the here? 0 plus 0, 0 plus 0 will be 0, 0. 5 plus 5 is 10, 1 carry. 7 plus 3 is 10, plus 1 is 11. We don't have here, so we are giving carry here. So it is 2 upon 6. No, here 5 plus 6 is 15. You are right. So what will be here? 21,000 upon 15. We have to do practical division. 21,000 divided by 15. 15 ones are 15. Here get it borrow, here will be 1, 11 minus 5 is 6, get 0 down, 9, 15 4s are 60, 1 0, another 0 means 2 0 we have to add here. So what will be that? Total salary of the worker will be average. What will be the salary of all worker together? How many workers? 9 plus 6 is total 15 workers. The each worker salary will be 1400 per week. So it was not easy to compare because there was having a different number salary amount as well as number of workers were different. So we have to go for average and we have to find that average. Now after average, everyone know unitary method, you had learned about this method, yes, which we use in our daily life, yes. Now I will give one example that the cost of 15 mangoes is rupees 60, what will be the cost of 20 mangoes? Yes, everyone can find out, yes, by unitary method, yes. First we have to find out the cost of one mango, then you can find out the number of mangoes in a large quantity also, you can find out the rate of mangoes. Now we will go over step by step. If you are given a cost of one object means it may be a mango, it may be a pen, it may be a table, it may be a chair, it may be a dining table, whatever it is, television, that is nothing but an object. How do you find the cost of many objects? If the cost of one, if suppose the television is costing 32,000, can you find out the cost of 5 television? I want to purchase a 5 television, what should amount I should manage and I should give to the shopkeeper? Yes, I know the cost of one television, so I can find out the cost of 5 television by multiplying. Yes, when you know the cost of one object, if you want to find in the many objects, you have to go for multiplication. You can do by multiplying the cost of one object with number of objects. Now only I told, one television was 32,000, I want 5, so you are multiplying 32,000 multiplied by 5. Whatever the amount you are getting, that is the cost of 5 television. Simple example I had given here, the cost of one pen is rupees 15. Because you are using this daily, so it will be very easy to understand. One pen is rupees 15, what is the cost of 5 pen? So one pen is, you know this, 15 rupees, 5 pen means you have to multiply 15 fives up. 75 rupees is the cost of an 5 pens. The cost of 7 pen is, what I had done here, multiplication, we will see another similar example, you will find out what type of an operations we have to do. Cost of 7 pen is rupees 105, find the cost of 5 pen. Now, I am having the cost of 7 pens, my father brought me a one packet of a pen which is having a 7 pen in the box whose cost of 105. But now I want to give to my friend, should I give without taking a money? No. Then he want 5 pen, then how much money I have to take from him? Yes, first we have to find the cost of one pen, then I will multiply it by 5, then we will get the total amount what I should take from my friend. So we will do this. So here I will write here up, cost of 7 pen is rupees 105, cost of 7 pen is 105 rupees, find the cost of 5 pen, cost of 1 pen is equal to, I told first I have to find out the cost of 1 pen. So what I have to do, I have to do the division. So I can do the practical division. Here is 105 divided by 7. 7 ones are 7. This is 3. I get 5 here down. 7 5s are 35. What is in the quotient is 15. So therefore, cost of one pen is equal to rupees 15. Now I know how much is the cost of one pen, and my friend is asking me how many pens? 5 pen. So I have to multiply, therefore cost of 5 pens is equal to how much? 5 into rupees 15. If you don't know table, I had given a trick, you have to multiply 5 5s are 25. To carry 5 ones are 5 and 2 is 75. How much rupees I have to take from my friend is rupees 75. What is that? Is nothing but cost of 5 pen. My dear student, this is an unitary method, so you have to understand the question first and then you have to do the operation. That is nothing but it should be a division or it should be a multiplication. The rent of a house is rupees 18,000 per year. Suppose I am a person, I don't have house, my own house, so I am having a rented house whose the rent of a house is 18,000 per year. Means what? In a year, we are having 12 months. So, 1 year is equal to 12 months. What is the cost of, what is the rent of my house for the 12 month is 18,000. For the 12 month, I pay 18,000 to my owner. What is the rent for 8 months? Suppose I want to go, I had got a transfer after 8 months. So, how much rent I should give to my owner? I have to calculate. I should not pay him 18,000 which was costed for 12 months. So, what should I do? Now, I will find out rent for 1 year is equal to 18,000 divided by how much? 12. How much? 12. So, you can write, you can divide, you can do a practical division. 12 ones are 12. How much is 6? 12 fives are 60. And this is 0. 1, 2 zeros are left. So, I will write here directly. It's 1500 what? Is the rent for 1 month is equal to, rent for 1 month is equal to how much? Rupees 1500. Therefore, rent for 8 months is equal to 8 multiplied by rupees 1500. Now, magic of zero, you can write two zeros together, write a rupees symbol. Now, you can multiply 8 fives are 40, 4 carry, 8 ones are 8 plus 4 is 12. How much I should give? Rupees 12,000. Rupees 12,000. So, I think so everyone understood how to calculate a rent for a month and the number of month, that is 8 month, which is given to us. Okay, my dear student, everyone understood this? Or we have to go for some more examples? Okay, you can try your own example, create your own example, and we are having a very similar examples in our textbook. So, you will find out what is in the unitary method, different types of example. Okay, thank you. Have a practice at home. Thank you very much.